We the cause of all the commotion. Your mouth running, but where's you going? What is you smoking, man? That ain't potent. What is you talking, man? It ain't important. Illuminati, high society. We in this party and nobody invited me. We going crazy, I always use my best sense. But it don't matter because I stay
here once again from ShortMeTina.com with my daily recap. Before we get underway, if this is your first time tuning in, if you're a first time listener, do us a solid here. Drop us a comment in the comment section. You can let me know your name. You can say hi. You can tell me how you found my channel. You can let me know what your struggles are when it comes to trading. Or you can just say, hey, simply, Tina, I'm listening. If you are returning again and you're tuned in or dialed in every so often, I want to say thank you as well. Feel free to comment. A lot of you folks do. You can just say, I just recently saw someone who just basically said hi or hello. It doesn't have to be anything elaborate. I just like to engage with the folks that are engaging with my content. Let's get underway. Right now, what you're looking at is the S&P 500, the SPY. Normally, when I do the video recaps, you're looking at a daily chart, and I generally do that because I'm not a day trader. I'm a swing trader, so I look at a bigger time frame. I don't generally look at intraday charts, but today we're going to go over the five-minute chart. So it's a five-minute chart dating back to March of 2019. So it's a five-minute chart for the past 2 months or so, but I really want to focus in on what has been going on since we recently hit all-time highs of around 295. I don't think we quite got to 295. I think we got to like 294.95, somewhere around there. So closed on Friday. We closed this past Friday. The news hits the airways. President Trump made a tweet in regards to tariffs in China, threatening to increase it by about 25%, right? That is the news headlines. That is the quote-unquote news headline. So let's dive into the chart, what's been going on. Again, this is a five-minute chart, but if you go back and you look at the chart for the past 2 years, starting from 2017, you'll realize, again, in my opinion, the SPY has been trading within a channel, right? The lower end of that channel comes in at 260. You don't see it on the screen, but the upper end of that channel comes in at around 280 to 282. You see that here. We finally broke through that channel right around here, around March of 2019. You can see it here. This blue line, this blue box, is that channel, the upper end of that channel that we broke out of. So here, this is 280, 282. So again, I said anything in my previous videos, I said anything above 280 to 282, we need to go long. Boom, we popped up and then we rallied to 295, and now we're getting this pullback here, right? This is all this week's worth of trading. And granted, we closed at 286.74 today, and I said, and I've been saying, if we pull back, that's fine, right? If we get into this blue shaded area, that should be okay. We should get a bounce if we ever get into this blue shaded area. And look what happened today, right? We got kind of close, going as low as around 283, and we got that bounce. But let's play out, or let's sort of examine what's been going on for the past week, right? Gap down on Monday, right? Close around 294 on Friday. Gap down on Monday, then we rallied. Gapped down on Tuesday. We sold off into Wednesday morning, and then we rallied towards the ending of Wednesday. What happened today? Opened up, gap down, late day rally. So what has been going on this week? We've had gap downs, right? Gap downs to start the morning, and then we had late day rallies. So Friday, tomorrow, what's going to happen? Are we going to repeat the theme overall for the week where we gap down, right? And if we gap down, that actually will be good, right? Because we're getting into that box area here. We're bouncing off a support of 280 to 282 and potentially rally late day Friday into Monday. Is that going to happen? I'm not sure. But again, if we remain above 280 to 282, we have to be bullish, in my opinion. So are we going to gap down tomorrow like we did this week? Or will we, as we did on Wednesday, end up having a midday rally? Let's see. What else? And then we have the IWM. Okay, so we're, again, intraday, 5-minute 5-minute chart dating back to March of 2019. What I wanted to highlight with this particular chart, again, this blue line denotes resistance. You should know that that's that 160 area that we haven't really traded above since I want to say October of 2018. So for the past 6 or 7 months, we really haven't hung out above this blue line, and it's so significant. You know why it's significant? You can see it right here. If you look at trading right here, the minute we got around here, we popped up a little bit, and then we had, in my opinion, quote unquote, for lack of a better way of phrasing it, violent selling. So that's a really significant level psychologically in the markets. And so I'm paying attention to that level. If we try to surpass it again, will we be successful? Will the markets sell off? The minute we can actually penetrate this level with volume, that should indicate to you, because it's going to indicate to me, there's been a complete shift in sentiment. Okay, so again, if you go back for the past 7 months, you'll realize this is just a 5-minute chart. You can just pull up a daily chart if you want. Go back until like September, October, you'll realize we haven't really traded above that 160 level for a very long time. Every time we made attempts to get there, the markets would sell off. And again, most recently we got to 160, penetrated above for about 2 days, market sold off intensely. So that should tell you, because it would tell me, if we get above that area, this area here that you don't see much trading because we haven't really traded above there for a very long time, if we can get up there, hold with confirming volume, in my opinion, complete shift in sentiment. What else? And then we have ticker CRON, another day of selling for CRON, off about 8.8% on the day, close to 9%. So another day again of selling in this particular pod stock, closed at 1409, going as low as 1390. So as you can see, and I've been saying for the past few weeks, although I see the stock going to around here, for the past 3 weeks or so, I have been in the shorter term bearish on ticker CRON, and I'm waiting for it to approach my buy zone. Based on my lines, you can see that it's entering, it's not there yet, but it's entering buy territory. And I do believe my buy zone, or our buy zone, will be triggered on CRON. I'm analyzing this and I'm talking about CRON to reinforce. And again, go back and watch my previous videos. You don't have to chase. I've been waiting since we can probably say March or April to actually re-enter this trade, right? That's about 2 months of sitting on my hands doing nothing, because again, it's quote unquote my way or the highway. I'm not chasing you, CRON. I want to purchase you, but I want to purchase you at a specified buy point. And if you do not get there, then I will not buy you, right? So I've been waiting, checking the stock at least every day, because I've been reviewing it every day. And again, it's coming into my buy territory. So put CRON on your watch list and your radar. I do believe that this stock can see $30, and sitting here at 14. And when I eventually decide to purchase it, it's gonna be a huge win if the stock goes my way. What else? All right, and then there's ticker NIO daily chart, up marginally on the day, closed at 460. So remember what I indicated before, what I'm paying attention to? I'm paying attention to all-time lows of around $4.43 right here. I said, well, when the stock gets back to this support area, this blue line here, what will investors do? Today, investors came in, stepped in, and they bought up the stock. It went as low as 451, not quite close, not quite 443, but very razor thin, very close to that level. So we know, we can say, at least in this instance for today, when the stock got relatively close to support, buyer stepped in. So I want that, I want to see that play out about one or two more times for me to say, well, this support level is a good area to go long. So to be continued. Still not in the trade at 460, a little bit too rich for my blood. What else? And then we have Roku, ticker R-O-K-U, daily chart up about 28% on the day. Huge move. Look at the volume here, right? Last print I saw, or I'm seeing right now, is $83.17. So again, huge move on the day. Huge rally since bottoming out back in December at around $27. So if you've been in this stock since December, great trade, great trade. I, unfortunately, I'm not in this particular stock. I have my reservations, but the chart looks decent, right? Overall, bigger picture, the chart looks decent. We can clearly see here, February of 2019 finally broke out of what I identified as a range, bounced around there for about 2-3 months, and we finally had that pop today. Even going as high again as 83.35, I would obviously exercise caution with any stock that has moved from $27 to 80 something dollars in the span of less than 6 months. So exercise caution. I can see it obviously popping another 3 to 5 points tomorrow, but expect your pullback. If not tomorrow, definitely heading into next week. So be cautious if you are thinking of jumping into ticker ROKU. I would wait for the pullback. What else? And let's round it out with ticker JD, up about 2.3% on the day. We've had a bit of a sell-off the past three trading days, with the exception of today. Today we saw a bit of a rally, and like I've indicated in my previous videos, it is approaching, in my opinion, buy territory when the stock was selling off. Again, remember, we got into this trade once it hit support of around $19-$20, saw it pop up to around north of 32, and I see 35 on the horizon. And I indicated when the stock was selling off these past few days, you know, pay attention to JD if you're on the sidelines and you miss this rally, because I believe it is entering, in my opinion, a good area to go long. Again, I eventually see this going to 35 before we run into any resistance, and hopefully, possibly, once we've sustained that move above 35, 50 is around the corner. So JD at this moment is looking not just as a trade, but a long-term investment. I see good things providing that the chart continues to act the way that it is. So let's cap it there. Tina, once again, from ShortMeTina.com. If you enjoyed any portion of this video, I'd like for you to do three things for me. One, comment in the comment section. Do you agree with my analysis? I did one on SPY, the IWM, CRON, NIO, Roku, and JD. If you do, comment. If you disagree, comment as well. That's okay. Secondly, if you want more videos like this, I do them Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Monday through Friday, you can expect a video. So head on over to our YouTube channel at ShortMeTina and hit that subscribe button. And lastly, I've been trading for over 15 years. If you think you can learn anything from me, then head on over to ShortMeTina.com. Sign up, become a member. Thank you for listening, and as always, thank you for the support. Get out my fucking head, this is me and my bad bitch. So you can say I'm on my Brad Pitt. Nah, back to the lot, familiar, I'm aligned with. Before I betray them, I slip my wrist. At the top, it's just us, nigga. I don't really trust niggas, and we made it through the hurricane, so celebrating like the Murray Jane. We gon' make it, that's on everything. Truest girls get half naked every spring. It's saying, hey Kanye, we need you to go deeper than Tayson Day, cause my verses got pain. Chocolate rain, so many lines you're photographing, it may on break. Woo! On the radio, man, I miss myself. I need to just step back and kiss myself. Baby, just step up and kiss the belt. A little lower, that's what's up. Somebody pour her another cup. Is it too much to ask you keep your diamonds up? I swear until my time is up, my style sex in the shower, fresh as fuck.